What's going on, guys? Dorkite back again. Hope you are fantastic today. And today we're going to be doing something a little bit different, where we're going to be reacting to the Banana Splits movie official trailer, which is apparently going to be on Sci-Fi. Now, the reason why I wanted to react to this is because it's quite similar to FNAF. It's a band of four characters with an old kids' TV show, and apparently they've gone all crazy and they're killing people and killing kids and stuff. So it's kind of similar to FNAF in a way, and Warner Brothers has the rights to this film, and people were saying, oh, because FNAF is now not with Warner Brothers, it used to be, but now it's not, they made the movie plot into this Banana Splits movie to, you know, make something with their story that they made that Scott rejected and things didn't go to plan, etc. I don't know the full story because I'm not Scott, but we know now the FNAF movie is being directed and stuff by Blumhouse instead of Warner Brothers. So, but Warner Brothers have now made this film, so that's why people are thinking, like, oh, they put their old plans with FNAF into this movie. So we're going to have a look. It's not going to be out in cinemas. It's a channel called Sci-Fi. I'd love to do like a reaction to this, like when the full movie's out, if you guys wanted it, if I'm allowed to anyway, or like a review or something, or talk about the plot and, you know, go through the film and see what's similar to FNAF and stuff, and things that we want and don't want in the FNAF movie. That would be really awesome. So we're going to do a reaction to this and then go back and then have a look, because, you know, it's pretty fun to do stuff like this. So first we're going to do the reaction. So play exclusive. So yeah, Sci-Fi Wire, never heard of it. There we go. So it's R-rated. Oh, so there's going to be a lot of la 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 la.
We are going to the Banana Splits.
Okay, so it's a show. Oh, it's in a warehouse. Night,
I see the splits riding around in the little cars, laughing and singing.
Who's excited to see the Banana Splits?
Rebecca, I'm canceling the show.
What?
Show's been canceled.
Hey, kids, put on your happiest faces. Because the Banana Splits show is about
what
to
the
begin.
Heck? Okay.
Mom, get out of here.
Time's almost up.
Oh, wow. Flamethrower.
Please.
Let me out.
Now the show can go on forever and ever.
Okay.
Come on, you fuzzy son.
Oh, it's a robot.
I just really want your brother's birthday to be perfect.
Whoa, okay. So they're robots now.
We're gonna have so much fun.
That sounded like Tigger from Winnie the Pooh. Okay, right, okay. So what I gathered is that the Banana Splits was a show in the 60s and 70s. My mum and dad know about it, by the way. I think there was a show, it got ported to the UK as well. Because I recognise that song. That song's been shown in the UK 100%, because I recognised it straight away. So, one banana, two banana, three banana, four. La, 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 la. But they were people in costumes originally, because, you know, but it looks like they've been made into robots now by somebody, and the robots have gone crazy. Kind of like the new Chucky film. Like Chucky used to be possessed by a man, but now it's like an AI gone crazy, malfunctioned. So let's have a look through it. So yeah, this is a Banana Split. So we've got a dog. I recognise this one. An elephant. Is that a camel? And I don't know what that is. I have no idea. It's like, I don't know what that is, guys. But that looks like a camel. And a monkey, maybe, or a fox, or a tiger, a lion. We get a better close. I have no idea what that is, guys. It looks like a monkey, but not at the same time. So there's the elephant at the circus. And the kid is a fan of the show. So we get that already. The kid likes the show, and it's his birthday. And for his birthday, he gets tickets to go and watch the show. Because I'm guessing the show you know, had an audience when they're like talking and stuff and presenting on the kids show, and there's people watching it, you know, like a normal kids show, you know, they have an audience and they record everything. So it's now in the present. And now it's still active at this time, and they've got tickets to go and watch it. And this is the warehouse where it's filmed and everything. The banana splits. They're going into the stage.
I see the splits riding around.
This is hilarious. So this is the security guard, and he says, this is a security guard, just like FNAF, and he says he sees them driving around in cars, laughing and singing.
Who's excited to see?
And look, it's all withered now and old.
See the banana split?
And here they are again, driving around. I have no idea what's going on.
Yeah.
And here they are, they're queuing up to go and watch it. And then this is it. It's like a rock out pillow fight, quick dash, jump, banana split. And then they're going rock out, because I'm guessing that's the best thing that can get on the wheel. This looks like a producer.
I'm cancelling the show.
What?
She looks like the director. And the stage light comes on and you see the dog just stood there. If you notice, guys, you can see the robot endoskeleton arm now. So in this now, so I'm guessing the plot is, the Banana Split 60s and 70s show used to be humans dressed up in the costumes, but now they are animatronics instead of humans, and that's why they're going all crazy. Well, they've been programmed to go crazy. Here's another shot, guys. So here's the, looks like the parts and services room, and you can see there's an endoskeleton hand, the robot inside a little chamber, probably being like implemented and like programmed and stuff. So definitely a parts and services room, just like FNAF, which is really, really interesting. Here's the gang again. I have no idea what this is. I think it's a monkey. Obviously, there are people inside these suits, but let's pretend they are robots. And there, here's the kid at the start who got tickets to go and watch. And there's the AI. The AI going crazy with the red eyes. Something's wrong. We know that.
It's about to begin.
I love the voices, though. The music's going distorted now. There's the kid again. And the kid looks like he gets lured by the elephant. Because we see here, holds his hand and then they go away. There's the mom. Oh, I don't know who that was. I think it was the kid again. Oh, I think that's a different person. And then the producer gets choked by the dog. Someone gets hit by a hammer. Flamethrower. He's got a time watch or something. And then the dad's running away. And there's a box. And then here's the real... It's this. I don't think that was the box. It was this, you know, magic trick, what you see in loads of horror films. Someone gets put in there and then gets chopped in half by the saw. That's definitely what's going to happen. Lots of blood and gore. Here's another stage set. The monkey thing's back. That girl from the... she was in the magician bit in the background while she watched a boyfriend get chopped in half. More kids running away. I don't know who that was. That looks like the show host or something. The host of the show in the suit. If you looked at the Banana Splits logo, there was a host man in a suit, and I'm guessing this is it. And there's the stage audience. Okay, this guy is interesting. I think this guy's the villain. I mean, this guy's the William Afton. The William Afton in this film, he is making the animatronics, and he looks crazy. I think he goes like, showtime. I think this guy's the loony who has programmed the animatronics to go in killer mode and kill anybody. Not just kids in the FNAF lore, anybody. Adults, everybody. And yeah, there's the flamethrower. Oh my God, their faces. So yeah, there you go, guys, look. So this is the doggo. You can see the endoskeleton with the red eye now. They are definitely animatronics, and now he's holding a flamethrower. So that guy there, who I just showed, programmed these animatronics to go and kill people, okay? It's as simple as that. And then there's the mom again. Looks like they're fighting back. What was that? What was that? It looks like, yeah, somebody just got hit at the back. Back of the head. No, wait, it's her. She's doing something, and then there's this guy in the background. I think that's the camel.
I just really want your brother's birthday to be perfect.
And there you go, the kid's got Lord. Bunch of bodies here. Bunch of rotten bodies in the basement or something. Like in the sewers, like below the stage facility, you know, where things get hidden. A bunch of bodies. And there they are back again. Yep, so there's the camel with the hammer. We go back again quickly. It's a nice quick shot. Yep, somebody's getting attacked. Endoskeleton is shown here with the arm. Camel's there. Hammer. Banana Splits movie. It doesn't actually look that bad. I wouldn't take it. Oh, that's definitely the Tigger voice actor. It actually doesn't look that bad, guys, honestly. Does it say a release date? Or it's just coming out for Blu-ray and digital? I'll probably, yeah, so you go. Warner Brothers guys here, by the way. Later this year. Oh, wait, it's coming to Blu-ray this summer and premiering sci-fi later on this year. So it's coming out very soon on Blu-ray. Definitely going to watch it, 100%. This could be a plot for FNAF, guys. I'm not even kidding. This could have been the original plot. I'm not going to confirm or deny it because I don't know. It's just a guess. Because this could work with FNAF. The no kids were possessing the animatronics. There was a crazy guy, William Afton. He designed the animatronics to go and kill people. Kind of like the Sister Location animatronics, where the animatronics were designed to just kill everything. That guy in the trailer, in the parts and services, the mechanic, definitely looked like a loony. And he seems to be the villain of the film. And he's designed the animatronics to kill people. So that's the plot, guys. For me, my guess of the plot, this was an original TV show in the 1960s, 70s with humans in the suits from Boomerang. And the show got cancelled and then it's back. But this time, they're actually animatronic inside the suits, not humans. And, you know, the show's back. Come and watch it. But the original, like, animatronic creator is a crazy man and he's programmed the animatronics, the AI, to kill people. That's why there's a bunch of bodies in the basement and he looks like he's crazy. That's my guess. And then we're obviously going to see the kid who's got the tickets, the mom and dad, fight against the animatronics and they win. And that's the end of it by the looks of things. So yeah, that could work well with Five Nights at Freddy's. I'm guessing that was the original plot. You know, Warner Brothers could probably change the story a bit to make it less complicated. You know, kids possessing animatronics and being a killer and the murder mysteries. I bet they wanted it to be a bit more simplistic, where they're like, oh, got a crazy mechanic guy programs animatronic AI to kill kids. And, you know, I can kind of see that working. And Scott maybe wasn't happy with it and changed it. And, you know, the film got cancelled and moved on to Blumhouse. So Warner Brothers said, hey, let's try and make this work with a different brand of animatronics. And it seems like they have. I wouldn't take it too seriously, though. It seems to be like a funny horror. But we'll have to wait and see. It might actually be creepy, but, you know, we can look at this trailer and think, oh, I'd like to see that in the FNAF film, or, oh, I don't want to see that in the FNAF film. Obviously, I don't want to see the animatronics humans being in the animatronic suits in the FNAF movie. Because, you know, this isn't even a full cinema movie that you're going to go and pay to watch. It's gone straight to DVD. So, you know, the budget of this film was probably low, so they didn't have the money to make, you know, real animatronics. So we'll have to wait and see what happens. But I don't want to see humans in Freddy Fazbear moving around. I don't think it will look well. Unless the suits are literally really, really good and detailed. And they're actually like moving as animatronics with people inside. Not fursuits like the ones that we've seen with the banana splits, okay? I don't want to see that. I don't think it will look good, knowing that they're animatronics, but we know that there's humans inside, you know, moving really clunkily. But we'll have to wait and see. So, yeah, it doesn't look that bad. I'll definitely check out the movie and maybe do a video about it, because it doesn't look that bad. It looks like a low-budget movie. But, you know, I can see this being quite entertaining, definitely. So I will check it out, and maybe I'll do a reaction to the movie or just talk about the movie in a separate video, what I liked, what I disliked, what was similar to FNAF. Because you can basically see it's very similar to the FNAF storyline. And, you know, this could have been an old script that was for FNAF, but they've moved it to the banana splits. So, yeah, let me know what you guys think. I will check it out. I hope you enjoyed the video. The reason why I did it was because a bunch of people were telling me to react to it and talk about it and, you know, give my own opinions about it. It's a bit of fun. I am going to watch it and tell you guys about it. But for now, we'll just have to wait and see. There's no actual release date. It says summer. So, yeah, let me know what you guys thought. I'll put the link in the description. Lots of love, and I'll see you all next time.